So student Lisa asks, what would be different in a world where almost everyone was programming literate?
So this is a cool question, and obviously I feel that it would be great to have such a world. That's why we're trying to encourage as many people as possible to take this class, and I hope you'll encourage any non-programming literate people that you know to take the next version of this class starting in April. There are lots of things that understanding programming, even at just a basic level, and I think many of you are beyond the basic level now if you've made it this far in CS 101, but in terms of the things that you interact with and the things that you see in the world, almost all of them are controlled by programs these days. And people who understand programming can relate to those things in a better way than people who don't. And some of this can be sort of fairly obvious things when you interact with a website and you can tell, well, they've got some bug in it because the programmer didn't think about both branches of an if test. And if you're a programmer, or you at least understand about programming, that you maybe have a better sense of what's going on, but you also can get a lot more annoyed by it because you know, well, this is something any programmer who knows what they're doing should have tested for and understood what was going on, and it's really annoying that you have to deal with their mistake. Other things, you probably have a better understanding of how complicated it is and how hard it is to get things right, that you might be a little more forgiving when things break and have better ideas about, well, this is probably why it's breaking, let's try to use this tool or use this product in some slightly different way. So that's one of the reasons. The other reason, I think, is there are lots of things that people encounter every day that if you know a little bit about programming, instead of doing a lot of tedious work as a human, you can find a way to automate that and save yourself a lot of stuff.
There's a good example of this right here in our office. So when recording these videos, we generate hundreds every week to get the classes out for all these courses. And they're all named kind of default things by the video camera, you know, video XXX124 and whatever. But what we need to do to edit them is organize them by like date and time and course and whatnot. And so one of our video editors wrote a script with just kind of the programming that she got from here and a little bit previously to do this automatically. Whenever we record videos, we just give it to her and she sorts it automatically and saves the video editors hours of time.
Okay, that's great. And I think people, once you get a little experience with programming, you'll see things like that every day, that you're seeing people, could be yourself, but it'll less often be yourself, spending their time doing tedious things that are not fun for humans, that you could write a few lines of Python code to solve. And so I hope at the end of this class, and I think by this point in this class, many of you really should be at the level where you're, instead of just solving the problems that we're giving you in the homeworks, you're finding real problems in your life and in your friends' lives that you can solve by writing a little bit of code. So I hope everyone will be doing that and spreading the value of programming literacy beyond just yourself.